try to don the immersion suit and then see, she's got the immersion suit it's red in color, which is her color. She's going to grab the suit by the handle on the back side and then shake it. It'll come right out onto the deck of the ship. Remember that the deck of the ship might be rocking in a storm wind by waves, so it's best to get down on the deck where it's safe. She's going to put one foot in a plastic bag and then put it down into the immersion suit. She's going to get into the immersion suit with the clothes that she's wearing on board the ship. So she's got her boots on, she's got her sweater on, she's got her jeans on. Notice that when she puts her feet in, they slide very easily into this suit. She pulls them up like a pair of pajamas, pulling them all the way tight. And while she has them tight, she snugs up the Velcro straps around the feet. This helps to mitigate some of the problems with air being captured low into the suit. Notice at the bottom of the suit, too, we have two purge valves. It's sort of an older suit. They don't really look like this much anymore, but nevertheless, that's what they are. Okay, she pulls it up. She's going to move to her knees now, still on the deck of the rocking ship, and she's going to put her weak arm into the suit. I'm going to put it all the way out until her hand comes to the very end of the suit, and then work the suit up over her shoulder. And then with her strong arm, she's going to pull the hood of the suit up and over her head. This gives her more mobility. She has more dexterity. And then she'll make sure she's got a good seal around her head, face. And then now she's going to take her strong arm and pull it inside like a chicken wing, extend it out into the suit, and pull it all the way back until it's all the way in. Okay, great. Now she reaches down and grabs one toggle with one hand and both hands on the toggle, pulls it all the way up. And then once she gets it all the way up, she'll have a nice seal all the way around the suit and her face. Leaning back does help with this. You can kind of lean back a little bit and pull it up. And then a lot of times it's necessary for additional crew members to help out. So she's going to help her out a little bit here. Okay, there she is. She's all covered up. She's got the face strap covering her. Okay. She's going to move to the side of the deck. She's going to purge all that air out of the suit now. There's a lot of trapped air inside. She bends down. She reaches up with one hand and pulls away at the cheek to allow the air to escape through the masks, and then snugs up the suit with her arms. Okay, it stands up. And she puts her inboard arm over her head toward the ship to protect her head. And the other arm is going to protect her face. So she puts it over her face. She looks down to make sure that there's nothing in the water, that the area is clear. And she's going to step sideways, bring her trailing leg behind the other one, and she steps up. There you go. And she's in the water. Okay. Pulls up the knee so she can breathe. Takes a couple strokes. There she is. Surviving. Notice this is the best way to swim in these suits. Just use your arms using a gentle back stroke. Okay, there she is. She's coming up onto the beach now. But one thing to mention in this, it's just a demonstration, but this suit is from the ship. Condemned. You probably saw that. It's a training suit. But it has no bladder. The bladder is our essential piece of this survival equipment. Once you're in the water, it's essential that you get that bladder blown up immediately. And many suits have ladders that have inherent buoyancy. I love them. They call them the best. But if you don't have inherent buoyancy, then you can pull that up and get it up right away. Okay. Thank you very much.